middle out. I mean, I was very glad he didn't get his own way, actually, because I think that would have destroyed the sound that you had. The sound, I had a fantastic amplifier, actually, which really enhanced it, which was a Marshall 600, which was a lead amp wired for bass. I don't know what they'd done to it, but it just sounded fantastic. And that gave the Unknown Pleasures a really distinctive sound. I actually got the chorus pedal at the end of Unknown Pleasures. So if you listen to Unknown Pleasures, it hasn't got chorus. Bernard introduced me to Electro Harmonics, a little shop on Deansgate in Manchester that sold them. And when I heard it, it just suited the high bass absolutely down to the ground. And I was just talking about it before, I've got 13 of the little buggers all lined up, and they break down all the time. I had 13, now I've got 12.
They're going down. Clone
theory? Yeah, the clone theory, yeah. And yeah, I mean, the sound just came from that, and I decided it was too thin, so I replaced the string on the bass. It's a 45. On my guitars, it's a 60. Which my son complains about greatly. I do 105, 85, 65, 60. Rips your finger off, but it sounds fatter, and it makes everything sound better when you play like that. So I've amalgamated a few things around it. But I mean, it was Ian. Ian, when I started doing it, because it was the only way I could hear, it was Ian that spotted it and would encourage you to do it all the time. And I must admit, I know I've come up with some, for say so myself, some pretty good bass riffs. I suppose that combination of the low slung bass and playing it high helped, because as my mother used to say, you do need a gimmick, Al Peter. It's a good gimmick, that she used to say, God rest her soul.
Next question, brother.